Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Rocket Monday, episode number 6. Today we're gonna take a look at ISRO, the pride of India. So let's dive right into it. So what is it? It's a Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, and it's owned by Government of India, as in it's directly a government organization. And it's first formed in 1969. There used to be an organization before that, but it was reformed, restructured, and now it's called ISRO. And its directly direct line of communication is to the Prime Minister of India. It's a government agency. So why it is? Now, many people know India as a poor country, and it was true 60 years ago, and ISRO was formed quite after that. So then question becomes, why a country that is having hard time feeding its people should invest in space? Here's the deal: if you see enough in the future, you will have realized we need satellite, and at that time satellites were becoming a big deal back in that day, just after independence, and moon missions were just being completed at that time. So to say satellites were about to play a very big role in our day-to-day life would not be an understatement. So everybody realized we're gonna need satellites. Okay, cool, you need somebody to make it, we got it. Now you made it, then the problem becomes you need satellite launchers. We have a lot of launchers also, and it's a part of national security. How does that affect us? Think of it this way: the reason why cruise missiles and ICBMs do very accurate targeting is because they have multiple layers of targeting system, one of which is GPS, global positioning system, like multiple satellites allowing it to aim properly. Now here's the deal: let's say a war breaks out, America can simply cut GPS signal to India, and we're like, boom, you're dead. So relying on something else to do your security is unwise. You generally want to make sure you have your own security. So we have created a Navi satellite system, NAVIC as it's called, and it covers up this much area. It's not global, it's not like anywhere on the planet, but it covers entire India plus a lot of the Asian continent, and it gives more accuracy than GPS. Not by that much. Like GPS for civilian use is rated to 10 to 20 meters. This is rated to 10 to 5 meters. So it's not day and night different, but it is more precise. However, it's only limited to this. And you want to make sure your nation is independent. Your communication, your direct to home TV, your phone communications, and your weather forecast, all these things require you to be independent. You can do it. You can go to other country and like how Pakistan does it, like, okay, they're gonna build a satellite and send it to someone else to like, okay, launch it. But it's not independence. So it was a very good investment. That's why it is. So we come to the good part. So we have to understand, it's the only government organization that pays back the treasury, like from budget the money goes into it and it pays it back. Now not 100%, like let's say 100 crore goes in, 100 crores comes out. No, it's not like that. However, because it does a lot of launching, all these satellite launches that we have, it does allow launch services, they do charge for it, and money goes back to the treasury. So this is very unique for ISRO, and it's slow. It's not like like SpaceX, like boom boom, five every minute they are doing iteration. It's slow but steadily, and they have been developing their own launch satellites. Like right now we have three main launch systems, and we have multiple satellite system, not one satellite system, multiple satellites. We have satellite system for navigation, we have satellite system for communication, we have satellite system for weather sensing. Like brick by brick, we're building this home, and ISRO has done a phenomenal job on this. Now, some of the great milestone: Chandrayaan 1, the moon mission that India did, became the first mission to found actual water ice on moon. The impactor that we sent, we orbited, we put the final nail in the coffin: is there water on the moon or not? So that's a big achievement. And Mars orbit, that Mangalyaan, it was called MOM, Mars Orbiter Mission, and it succeeded in first attempt. That's the only country we ever pulled that off, is India. So surprisingly very, very large achievement. And now everything is not good and dandy, but So now let's look at the bad. Now we have to realize the biggest launcher we have is PSL. All Indian rockets are named SLV, satellite launch vehicle. So either it will be have P, which means for polar, or it will have G for geostationary. Now the biggest rocket is this, which you can see it has only 10 ton to low Earth orbit. To give you an idea of that, how does that compare to the world, it's Falcon 9 has 20 ton to low Earth orbit, actually 22 ton to low Earth orbit. So it's not very powerful. It's there, it's a medium lift rocket, but we don't have heavy lift rocket. Now this is kind of like, we are still developing it. Like I told you, India is very slow and steady, so we are still needs foreign agency. A lot of our satellite is launched by European Space Agency because we still need some heavy satellites that go into geostationary orbit, which India cannot do just yet. Now all those things, I have faith in ISRO that it will be solved. However, one thing that makes me bleed, cry in agony is their PR. They don't have good footage of anything. Not anything is covered properly. They just few days ago in this month, they did a launch abort system test, which is basically if your rocket is on the pad and let's say they detect a malfunctioning rocket and rocket is about to blow up, they will abort the capsule which has the people in it. It's an old system, it's not like, you know, new idea. Many system has it, and you know, even Saturn V, the moon rocket, also had this, and even Soyuz that we use nowadays to go to space also has it. So it's not a new idea, but India was like, you know, developing their own system and testing it. This is the best video I got of it. It's like ish, and it has frame rate of 15 frame per second. The cameras that was on board that were like, you know, showing the parachute deployment and all that, it was so bad. Like if this is what is shown to the outside world, including Indian public, they're gonna like feel like this. The video footage literally looked like it was shot in 2005 maybe. Like it's unbearably ugly. Like compare this to even a private company like SpaceX, how they launch it, or even a government, how NASA does it with ULA launch system. The profession, the proficiency of the why they are tracking the, you know, pod and all that, it's phenomenal compared to this ISRO. Now ISRO is not cheap. It's spending like 10 to 20 crore on even small things, and overall budget is $1.8 billion, basically 10,000 crore or something like that. So saying that they could not afford GoPros and put it on, like, are you serious? This was really bad. This is the reason why ISRO is not seen as a pride of India, because the even though we are the one that launched 104 satellites, if you see that footage itself, you'll be like, dude, which camera you are using? Is this camera made in 1998? Like, they really need to up this. Otherwise, the national support, so to say, it's like, it looks embarrassing. Like, this footage is so bad that SpaceX rocket blowing up has much more detailed footage. So let's come to why I call it the pride of India. So India is a growing country, and almost every country on this planet has some form of corruption. India has, like, you know, some organization have a lot of corruption, some has little, but this one has almost no. It's not absolute zero, but it's almost negligible. So this gives us a pride factor, like, you know, we don't have to worry about this having corruption. And it has great achievements, like all other achievements that we do. It's kind of small scale, like, you know, we did this dam that has this much capacity. It's not world leading, it's just like, it's good for India, you know, like best in India or things like that. But this achievements that ISRO is doing, like launching 100 plus satellite in one go. The second largest amount is 38. So we went from 38 to 108, directly three times. So suffice to say, if you say ISRO's achievement to the world audience, it's honorable. The fact that we discovered water on moon, the fact that we have a Mars mission and successfully achieved it in the first go, these things cannot be understated. Like, ISRO's achievement is on a global scale. It's not like, oh, best for India, oh, best for Asia. No, it's best for the planet. Like, you know, it's something like, you know, global leaders do. And you have to understand, only elite countries have space program. For instance, Pakistan, having the same age as India, like, you know, we were both created at the same time, does not have any space program like it has space program, but they don't have satellite launch capacity, and even the first satellite they made was made with the help of, you know, Chinese people. So suffice to say, very few countries, like there are 70 space organization that is, you know, country owned, however only few are at the scale, capacity and performance of ISRO. ISRO is ranked like 4th and 5th. It's not a bad achievement, and it's world class in price to performance. What does that mean? This is the sole reason why ISRO has so much reputation, because it was designed as to make money in return. Like, you know, we provided launch platforms for other companies, private companies or countries. We worked very hard to make sure our satellite launchers are cheap, and you know, they do the job for least amount of money. To give you an idea, making movie in Hollywood costs $70 million. Our Mars mission costs the same amount of money. So price to performance, we are almost at the same level as SpaceX. That's the whole point. Now, of course, we can't beat it, and SpaceX over time will exceed us. But even though for a government agency to have this sort of price to performance ratio, it's phenomenal. So these are my reasons why I consider ISRO the pride of India. I hope you do like this presentation. If you learned from it, please like. If you didn't, dislike and subscribe. Press the bell icon. I make video every day. Thanks for watching.